Yes. Next, that is your diagnostic evaluation. In diagnostic evaluation, as I said earlier, that is first history, that is medical history, means whether you have recently had a cold or flu, then whether you smoke or spend time around the other who smoke, then whether you have been exposed to dust, then fumes, vapors or your or air pollution. Then next, mucus, to see whether you have a bacterial infection. Then this is in your history. Then chest x-ray, lung functioning test, then CBC and ABG analysis. Then in management, medical management, surgical and your nursing. In improve ventilation for use of bronchodilators like beta-2 agonist, for example albuterol. Then anticholinergics, then corticosteroid and oxygen administration. Then remove bronchial secretion, promote exercises, control complications and improve your general health. In surgical management, it means in severe case there is need of your surgery. Then second, that is emphysema. So what is emphysema? Emphysema is it is defined as enlargement of air sacs distal to terminal bronchioles with destruction of their air walls of the alveoli. Emphysema, it means, or it is a enlargement of air spaces. I'm repeating, the enlargement of air spaces distal to the terminal bronchioles with destruction of their walls of the alveoli. This, it means emphysema. Then what is pathology for this? As the alveoli are destroyed, the alveolar surface area in contact with the capillaries decreases. Then it causes dead space, that is no gas exchange takes place, and due to this no gas exchange, it causes hypoxia. And later then this CO2, that is carbon dioxide elimination, is disturbed. It means there is no proper in and out, there is exchange of gases. There is, due to this, CO2 elimination is disturbed and increase the CO2 tension in arterial blood. It means CO2, there is no proper elimination of CO2. Due to this no proper elimination, what will happen? That is CO2 is increased, and due to this CO2 tension is increased on arterial blood and it causes deoxygenation. It means respiratory acidosis. Then there are different emphysema, that is centrilobular, then second panolobular. In centrilobular, the respiratory bronchioles, that is proximal and central part of acinus, is expanded. Then second, and it is occur mainly in the or commonly in upper lobes. Then panolobular, the entire respiratory acinus from respiratory bronchioles to alveoli is expanded, and it is more commonly occur in the lower lobes, that is especially for basal segment and the anterior margins of your lungs. Then for a diagnosis, for that history, then PFT, spirometry. In spirometry, to find out airflow obstruction. Then ABG analysis. Then CT scan of lung. Then screening of alpha antitrypsin deficiency and X-ray. Same management of the treatment, medical, surgical and nursing. In medical treatment, in for improved ventilation, use of bronchodilator, for example, like beta-2 agonist, that is albuterol. Then anticholinergics, then corticosteroids and oxygen administration. Same, remove the bronchial secretion, then promote exercises, then control complications, and third, that is improve general health. And in case of your सीवियर और सीवियर इफ इट इज़ मोर सीवियर इट देर इज नीड ऑफ सर्जरी. आई विल स्टॉप हियर.